afternoon. It's Friday. Hope you had a good week. We're going to get started with a quick warm-up here. And today we're going to be looking at a silhouette and drawing the negative space. So, I have a reference picture here. And we are going to draw the white space around the figure. The white space here is the negative space. So we can look at each shape. So like this shape here, it's kind of like a triangle. So I'm going to start kind of here. Like a triangle with a little dip. About a centimeter away. And this triangle has a little dip. Okay, we're just looking at the space around. So I'm actually going to use my ruler to block off the figure. So it's easier to see the bigger spaces. Okay, that way we can see the smaller negative spaces a little bit better. Okay. So from here, we drew this one, which is here. We drew this triangle shape, which is here. If we think there's another, like 1 centimeter space, we'll just mark that for now. I think I'm gonna leave this big shape till later. And then down here is another kind of 1 centimeter space. And then at the bottom, there's a little notch. And I'm just drawing the white part, which is the negative space. Okay, so if you're just joining, we are doing a warm-up by looking at the negative spaces of this picture, which happens to be the white space. Okay, if it's easier for you, you can draw in your square first. I kind of just started in the middle. I started with this one and then I drew this one. I looked at the distance between the white spaces, the white shapes, and I drew those in. Now I'm just down here, this bottom white space here. That's what I'm going to draw now. Okay, so hopefully you can see this shape that I drew here is this shape, roughly. Okay, next we're gonna draw this negative space up here. So I'm gonna continue down here. And it helps if you draw in the square first, I guess, but I didn't start with that. But here we are. Okay, so this white space here is this white space here. Hopefully you can see that the figure is starting to show as I draw in the white space. Looking at the negative space is equally as important as looking at the positive space, because that's a good way to check if you're drawing accurately or not. I'm going to continue this line for my box here. Okay. And I'm gonna go over here because here's another little small space. It's gonna be a little sliver of white space there. And there's like a little mountain range. And then it just connects. Okay. And for this space that's really big, you can divide it into parts so it's easier to see. So I'm going to divide it into 1, 2, kind of like quarters. I'm going to sketch in those lines here as well. Okay? They're just extra guides because that was a really big space to look at. So now I can just focus on looking at this white space here and drawing that. So about here. So you're just looking at this white shape, which is the negative space. And the bottom, there's a little notch here. I'm a little bit off. That's because I started kind of in the middle. But it's all good. So here, this whole thing is the negative space. And down here, something like that. And then this line I kind of estimated from before. Okay. So, kind of like that. Okay. So that's really quickly looking at negative spaces, trying to draw that. Okay. So we will move on to our doodle along for today. For today, we have Mermaid 2020, and it's day 15. And our prompt today is rescued. So I will draw two figures, I think, one rescuing the other. We're going to start with basic shapes. So here we go. I'm going to draw a head over here. And the body will be curved this way. And then there's going to be a figure that's being saved here. I think I'm going to draw Lammy being saved. So this little ball here is going to be Lammy's head. Just remember that for now. Okay, and here is like a body shape. And an arm. Kind of holding up Lammy's head. And the other arm on the other side. Okay, and the tail is gonna come loop around this way. Like so. Neck. And I'll just draw kind of a basic shape for Lammy's body. He's kind of floating. He's being saved. Okay, and so hands are going to be here. Draw in an ear. And now I'm just going to fix the face a little bit. And I'm drawing the line here to show where the eyes are going to be, kind of looking downward. Okay, and I'll draw some hair. Slow down a little bit here. And remember, everything I draw is just a suggestion. You can do your own version as well. Decoration in her hair, I guess. You can decide on the type of decoration or the type of hair that you like. I'm gonna give her kind of a shell crown. Drawing her eyes. Her eyes are kind of looking this way and a little bit downward. You're not going to see this eye too much. I'm just going to draw the hint of where her eye is going to be. But you'll see her eye over here. And to make her look a little bit concerned, I'm going to draw her eyebrows kind of curved this way. And eyebrows. And a nose. And just define Lammy's head a little bit more here. Lammy has ears like so. And his face shape. And because he was just saved, maybe he's resting. So his eyes are closed. His nose is a Y shape. While you catch up, I'm going to kind of decorate this mer person's clothing. Give her some fancy sleeves. Bracelet. Her hand. And her tail here. This time I'll do more angular scales, I guess. I'm doing quick rounded scales. This time I'll do some V-shaped ones. If you have other ideas, go for it. Her hand a bit better here. There's a thumb and some fingers. Then we have some hoofs. Okay, and then he's not drowning, he's out of the water, so let's draw kind of like the hint of water around him. So the mermaid's kind of looking, or kind of saving him above water. She's just partially submerged. This mermaid queen or princess has saved or rescued Lammy. Alrighty, and that's what I have for you today. My challenge for you is to fill a whole page with doodles of one of your favorite cartoon characters going about their day. What is a day in the life of your favorite cartoon character? The quote I have for you today is, "Creativity is the way I share my soul with the world." I hope you have a good day and a good weekend, a good long weekend, and I'll see you on Tuesday. Bye!